what I've done basically in my life is made people experience pleasure. I've not killed millions of people. I've killed one person trying to kill me and my family. Because I was the most successful pornographer in Soho. I simply was prolific. I made a film every couple of weeks. I had 60 photos a week. I went around the shops on Friday with the new sets. And there are actually people in there waiting for my new photos. You've been blackballed by those above. It means you've got to go, you're walking dead, man.
I say to the children's minister, try to calm down and behave like an adult and... Order! Order! Miss Order! 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 I say to the children's minister, try to... Order! I say to the children's minister, try to calm down and behave like an adult, and if you can't, if it's beyond you, leave the chamber, get out. In order! Order! Miss Order! 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 Leave the chamber, get out, we'll manage without you. Order, I say to the children's minister, try to calm down and behave like an adult, and if you can't, if it's beyond you, leave the chamber, get out. Miss Order! 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 Order, I say to the children's minister, try to calm down and behave like an adult, and if you can't, if it's beyond you, leave the chamber, get out, we'll manage without you. Miss
The greatest form of control is where you think you're free when you're being fundamentally manipulated and dictated to. One form of dictatorship is being in a prison cell and you can see the bars and touch them. The other one is sitting in a prison cell, but you can't see the bars, so you think you're free.
What the human race is suffering from is mass hypnosis. We are being hypnotized by people like this. Newsreaders, politicians, teachers, lecturers.
We are in a country and in a world that is being run by unbelievably sick people. The chasm between what we're told is going on and what is really going on is absolutely enormous.
All my wolves begin to howl, wake me up, the time is now. Oh, can you hear the drumming? Oh, there's a revolution coming.
Wide awake, the fever burns, sweat it out, lay my turn.
Been stealing, can't let time.
from the bottom. Can't hold me down, hold me down. I'm rising up, up from the ground. From the bottom. Can't hold me down, hold me down, hold me down. All my wolves begin to howl. Wake me up, the time is now. Can you hear the drum?
I said sincerely. And you can tell that the government's heart...
Order! Forgive me.
Oh, sorry. The
government's heart does not appear to be in this deal. And I think listening to those who are sent out to defend it and to explain it, they know that it is a democratic disaster. In fact, after 2 years of negotiation, as has already been said, I think it has achieved an extraordinary thing in the sense that it has brought us together, finally.
Order! Order! Miss Order! 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 Order!
This is intolerable behaviour as far as the public... No, it's not funny. Only in your mind, Mr. Lawton, is it funny. It's not funny at all. It's disgraceful. Order, I say to the children's minister, try to calm down and behave like an adult, and if you can't, if it's beyond you, leave the chamber, get out.
Being judged for choosing to have children or not have children, to have children and go back to work, to have children and not go back to work, for being too thin, too fat, too pushy, too unambitious, too hot, not hot enough, or even for just daring to be alive, women have stressed that everyone can go fuck themselves.
This is intolerable behaviour. As far as the public... No, it's not funny. Only in your mind, Mr. Lawton, is it funny. It's not funny at all. It's disgraceful.
Order!
Leave the chamber. Get out. We'll manage without you. This is intolerable behaviour. As far as the public... No, it's not funny. Only in your mind.
As has already been said, I think it has achieved an extraordinary thing in the sense that it has brought us together, finally.
Nathan Muir has been gauging the reaction because apparently a man is the best person to report this story.
If you have a vagina, people have the right to judge you on every single thing you do, even what you do with your vagina. Or so it has been up until now. I spoke to one of womankind, or the clitorati, as no one is calling them, about their backlash.
Enough's enough. The message is clear, and the message is, you're right, we will do as you command. Just kidding, it's fuck off.
That's all from me.
As has already been said, I think it has achieved an extraordinary thing in the sense that it has brought us together, finally.
This video is going to be lots of little clips very quickly because attention spans and all the rest of it, and you're all very busy. But first thing I want to say is the Brexit Trail March went off yesterday without a hitch. I spoke to the police along the way. There wasn't one single arrest. They said, you guys have been great. So I thought, brilliant. What are the opposition going to say about this? Now, behind us, I'm going to show you the clip. It'll be muted the whole time. And this was from RT, who videoed this. And you'll see how many people are there. All we're asking for is for Brexit to be handled in a professional manner, and leave means leave. It isn't asking much. And at the moment, they've managed to fudge everything. Whether we actually get to leave or not, it remains to be seen. However, I would suggest that if we don't leave, the things that are happening over in France, Paris at the moment, not feeling very good after yesterday, could end up happening here. Now, I wouldn't want to see it. I don't want to see people getting hurt and damaged to the streets of London. Central London's a very beautiful place. Admittedly, there may be other parts of London that aren't so nice and look more like some third world country, but that's another thing. This march was never about Tommy Robinson. Tommy Robinson said this. It was about Brexit. And we knew there was a lot on the line here. We knew that if there was just the smallest hint of trouble, then Gerard Batten's position would be untenable. And everybody could say, we told you so. But, much to my surprise, because I thought we were going to have everything thrown at us, the police were absolutely fantastic. I've got to say, they were lovely, full of smiles, talked to us, which was a complete difference to the way they'd been to us before. But, thank you, police force, you did a great job. And you made us actually feel comfortable. So, well handled there. So where do we go from here? We need to share this as much as possible. Not just my opinions, but other people like this. Get the message out there. We're on the right side here, people. We're not mean, we're not horrible, we're not violent. How much alcohol did you see in that march? How many tattoos did you see in that march? A few. But actually, the fashion worldwide now is to have tattoos, and I'm quite rare because I don't. There you go. Anyway, that aside, I also want to say a massive thank you to all the people that came up and shook my hand. It's very, very strange. I live on my own, and I'm a lorry driver, so I spend most of my time alone. So being around big crowds is mad anyway, but having so many people come up and shake your hand and say so many nice things, it's just completely overwhelming. So if I seemed a little bit, oh, he wasn't that friendly or whatever, I was just, literally, I was absolutely gobsmacked. I'm still on a high from it now. It was amazing. And I just can't thank you enough for your support and your kind words and all the advice you gave me and everything else. So yeah, thank you very much. And we'll see you on the next one.